not the Rocket Wine for $1.09 a quart. It's not the fine motel down near the fountain court. And it's not the automobile manufactured by Ford. It's Thunderbird Theater, cable cast from Buffalo.
Hey, Bucket Man, what time is it right now?
It is righteous beverage.
Bucket Man!
It's Thunderbird Theater time!
It's 8:30! Friday night, isn't it? In the city of Buffalo. And what channel are we gonna put on?
Channel 32.
Just doing my theme song to one of my favorite shows, Art Waves, there. A masterpiece it is. If you two would like to play piano like that, you can take the Bishop of Riverside's seminar at the Gallery Mundane, which puts out this magazine. See, we're celebrating Easter at the Gallery Mundane with the Riverside Art Scene with the Risen Christ. See, that's like the Soundgarden Jesus Christ pose there, and that's the Jesus Christ posse. And, they're celebrating Desert Storm and the NFL and all this good American stuff here. So you can pick up your copy of this thing. We usually leave them hanging around hall walls and squeaky wheel to stir up trouble. And watch Video Mundane Saturday morning at 9:30 a.m. We're gonna have a special Thunderbird Theater about Video Mundane one of these weeks at the Bishop Riverside showing clips, along with our guests C-Bag and D-Bag. Well, you're wondering what I got here. You know what I got here? Sure, you get a nice shot of this. Satan Claus brought me this stuff for Easter. Brought me eggs with nothing in them. Sort of like the television viewing audience's minds. So fertile and empty, and I like to fill it. Well, let's see what we got in here. Oh, use these to power your refrigerator, as it were. Refrigerator Perry's ice cream, that is. Yeah, the Bob Hope Chicago Bears, Brooke Shields, Emmanuel Lewis, Gary Coleman, Holiday, and the Crawl Space Bears batteries here with the big Cincinnati Reds logo and a black helmet. How come they got Cincinnati Reds logos on Bears helmets? I could never understand that. They're super heavy duty, just like Judas Priest. They're heavy duty. They're going to prove to all the world that metal rules the land, as is Spinal Tap, because they have a song called Heavy Duty. Okay, they're size C batteries. Nothing I know uses size C batteries except, some girl I know's vibrator. She keeps it in the refrigerator with those frozen bananas. Well, on to something better. We got Halley's Comet, Haley Mills Comet, Bill Haley's Comet, Comet, like the 64 automobile made by Chrysler Plymouth, like Dodge Darts, like, damn empty eggs. Well, get a nice shot of this thing. You see what it is? It's the Halley's Comet telescope, like Telesavalis scope, like scope mouthwash, like a spy scope, like buyers today. It's on the moon there. and it says, follow the comet with this unique telescope. Complete story of Halley's Comet included. Don't miss out on this once-in-a-lifetime event. Look at moon craters. You know where you can look at moon craters? There's this really ugly person I know who works at a convenience store, so to speak, and his face is just filled with moon craters. I'm squeezing those zits too much or something. It's from the Republic of China, patent pending number 7430341, and it's made in Taiwan. Another good Xmas gift. In Easter. Easter in March, or Christmas in March, or Halloween in November, as it were. Like we celebrated a few shows ago with Salty the Sailor. We got the 911 as a joke rescue bar here. You see, there's Mr. Cop. His name's Pat. Like Pat Buchanan. Not Puke Cannon, but Buchanan. He's gonna get rid of the NEA for good. See, there's 911 on his badge and 911. And Mr. Buchanan, he's policing the art scene, as it were. It saves appetites by suppressing things like maple bark pictures that make you puke. For those of you who don't know, I saw at the Village Green's a maple bark thing. It looks like a regular old porno mag. It's got girls in it. So if you're offended by the male pictures, you can get the one with the girls in it and not be offended. And here we got 911 as a joke, Mike the Fireman. See? 911, 911. And he also saves appetites. That's solid milk chocolate. Heh. The chicken brought me this stuff. You see up here on the 33 West piano, we got a replication of my friend Chicken up there. Get a good close-up of that chicken. I do love that chicken. It's a Kentucky Fried Arkansas Fried Chicken. Heh. Since I'd be called KFC now, like MDC or JBH. Since everything's initials. Like initializing your computer, of course. No Easter would be complete without a couple sundry issues of this wonderful thing, the Riverside Art Scene. Articles galore. Bet you all want to get one of these. Sure you do. All kinds of nasty stuff in it. But you'll just have to go spy around the art scene if you want to get one.
Did I send away for a few, yeah?
You'll probably send away right to our address at the end of the show and we'll send you one. They're free. For now, hey. we got my favorite. Gummy Sour Road Pets. Get a good close-up of this label. See, that's a punk skunk? That's punk skunk that I found in the garbage. And he's getting run over here by this pacer thing. This guy's going like, he got his thumb up like Fonzie. It's like Fonzie in there. And it's like thumbs up because he ran over a skunk, and it's a gummy sour road pet. That's Trolley, the one for fun because it's fun to run over skunks. I think of real fruit juice. I thought it'd be made of real skunk juice, possum juice, dead deer juice, and whatnot. Well, that's a fun product. Alright. And we got, of course, pink Easter grass in this crazy, crazy basket here because, pink. Because it's a silence equals death egg. There's nothing in it. It must be silent, so it must be dead. Like a Grateful Dead. What else we got here? Got purple. Purple like my purple helmet. We got blue. Blue like my, like, Bucket Man's balls before I cut them off. And we got yellow. Like the stripe that runs down Bucket Man's back. And the color of the chicken, too. And the color of my favorite nectar for drinking. Thunderbird, that is. You might have thought I'm an earring. Okay, look what we got here. Yeah, pink silence equals death marshmallow peeps, and yellow golden showers peeps. Springtime dress-ups. Sorry, transvestism. Walk in the woods. Oh, you put that little dress on that chicken. It's probably a boy. Yeah, it'd be just like on Radosh Madness over at that crazy place on Niagara Street where me and the Bucket Man and the Bishop were seen spying the slideshow. Alright, now here's something else on the show. Bust up this boredom.
Let's go out looking for the bathroom. Isn't it great that you don't get erections anymore when you gotta take a piss? Because now you don't got any testicles? Isn't that great? It's great! It's like when you used to go to All Saints School and you really had to go to the bathroom. But you couldn't, because they would never let you go the whole day. So anytime you had to go, you get this like erection, you couldn't even take a piss, and you had these polyester pants, and you got this big boner, you couldn't go to the bars, you'd be afraid the teacher would see you.
shattered glass is a pretty.
Ah, Bolsonaro! Bucket Man's talking about making chicken a capon. You know how they take the capon and they castrate him? So he's now, instead of a fierce rooster, he's now a friendly, fat capon. It's the same thing about deciding to send your kid to an all-boys school or not. Like St. Charles or Canisius. Because you send them there, and then you know what happens? They become basically castrated because they don't have any girls for 4 years, except some fat girls from Mount St. Mary's or Sacred Heart. And you get to hang around big, stupid sheriff's sons who don't know anything. And then they go around and it's like castration. They give you mental blocks. They give you all stupid things to think about. And you gotta do sentence combining. It's the same thing. Castrating a rooster, sending him to St. Joseph.
No, demasculating the masses in town.
Demasculation. Demasculation. It's like a...
Wait, we were emasculated.
I know, but it's like a, you know what it is? It's a development house for bucket men. Hey, look, drinking fountain. Yeah. Oh, look, it works as good as a fountain. It's a drinking fountain, just like the fountain court, and it works as good too, look. Look at all that water coming out. Hey, take a piss in here, bucket man.
So are you taping?
Yeah, I'm taping.
Usually don't do anything, you know, there with the ski-mask team there, castrated Buckman being there, and that, you know, that bishop, I haven't been to church in a while, you know, I should see a couple novenas, you know what I'm saying? Well, anyways, as you can see, I was in effect with my Raiders, my starter, of course, they got the starter there, and, you know, because I wouldn't use anything else, you know, I was in effect. Well, anyways, I want to talk to you all about, I got these hype cards here for my, cousin Tony sent him out there from New York City. He's he's been sending me these cards over the time. He's always telling me things. Well, actually, he must not like this one because I sent him this one out there to him. As you can see here, the first card we have is Can You Picture Me in Buffalo, New York there. And I think that's Snoopy or Lassie or something there. I'm not sure. He's I think that is. I think that's some kind of well, some kind of sport team, I'm not really sure.
Talk more towards the mic,
can you hear me now?
It's down here. Like right there.
Like right down here?
Perfect.
Perfect, eh? Is it perfect? Okay. Okay, well, you can see this here. Got like Snoopy or something. I don't know about the, you got the San Jose shot cutters on there. And, he's got the ready. This is a card that he sent back. As you can see, it says, can you picture me here in Buffalo, New York? You know, Buffalo, New York, home of Toons. And I open it up there, and it says, sure, been painting the town red. You see what he's doing? Is he's one of those pro dogs there with the San Jose Sharks. And he's painting the town red, and the red he got from the blood of the fetuses there that, they have been cutting up for, so. And that's where he got the blood. He's, chopping up all those babies and using the blood to paint the town red, you know, the fetus blood there. That's one card right there. Hey, what's up? And hey, look, you know, it's got some babies. She's got some, boob action there. She's also got the San Jose thing in effect up here. And down here, she's got some Philadelphia Eagles. But, so I ain't mailing. Then you open it up. Hey, look, it's my buddy Italian there. You ain't exactly modeling yourself. You got yourself an ape there.
Marlon Perkins.
Marlon Perkins. Hey, like I used to watch the, Mutual of Omaha, Wild Kingdom. I don't know about that Omaha, Dave. They don't have any good sport team like, the Chiefs or something there. Well, actually, you can't exactly marlin yourself. You see how that works there? He's got the cop outfit. I think he just got done beating up Rodney King. You know what I'm saying there. But, next here we got, quite an interesting hobby you have. And, he's trying to get a little knee action there. He's trying to, he's trying to knock some boots like the Candyman there, trying to get a little feely. And then I open it up there, and you see, oh no, man, oh boy, this, even this big time strong, holy shit, got the baby there. So I see, obviously, they didn't listen to, that poop when he was just in the womb there. But it says, and it really pays off. Congratulations, couldn't grant. I don't know what it says. I can't really read it there too well. But anyways.
It's a long word. It's hard for me.